Sound system ready? Toll-free line operational?
We've got a dial tone.
Projectile vomit man, bucket on standby.
That's a check.
Dak, have you got a gross hospital story ready?
Ready to go.
Drexel, grab 2 12-packs of Dr. Pepper out of the fridge.
You betcha.
Video camera, is the video camera rolling?
Up and running.
Have we spammed everyone on ICQ? Is it working?
No problem.
Broadcast feed ready to go? Is WinApp geared up?
That's a check.
Anybody in the IRC yet? Damn, NetSplits. Everybody got their headphones and microphones on? Let's go!
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Yo, 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 here we are in the house.
To What the Hell on Rant Radio.
That's right, another wonderful, awe-inspiring, gut-wrenching, another...
Tear-jerking.
Throw some more adjectives in
throw
there.
Throw some, insert adjective here.
Blue,
box-like.
Blue.
Angry. It's a happy, sad show. Mean,
I
angry
laughed,
show.
I laughed, I cried, it became a part of me.
I laughed, I cried, it was better than cats. Okay, so, how's everyone out there tonight?
I think everyone's pretty good.
Yes, they probably are.
Look at them all. Look at them all.
14 minutes late starting. Look
no,
at
no,
that.
There was a song. There was about 6 minutes long.
That was about 6 minutes long. That was pretty fucking good, though. They actually made direct reference to the cult.
Yes, join, they did. Join a cult.
Join the cult.
Join the cult?
Join the cult.
No, they didn't say the.
Shut up. They said join the cult.
I remember. I remember. Yes, I remember that.
Absolutely.
Now.
These are the droids you're looking for.
Yes, they are. Well, so, it's April 23rd, 2000, week number 69.
69!
Of What the Hell? It's a stupidity you've been waiting 6 days and 22 hours to hear in front of the possibility of 6 billion people.
That's
6 billion people.
6
Can
billion
people. Can
you
fathom people?
That? Wow, that's America Online. 6 billion people. Wow, it's so easy. Hey, why don't we go around the room and see who's there? Who's going to be the
we
camera
could.
Bitch tonight?
Am I going to be the camera bitch?
No, you're
I
the camera
so.
Bitch. No.
Nope. Oh, Kurt's getting up.
Kurt is being the camera bitch once again.
He's the only one that knows how to
And as an extra special thing, as Kurt Burt goes for the camera, we have a triumphant return and sorry departure of the chicken.
Dun, dun, dun.
Dun, dun. Dun! The chicken is going to be leaving us for 4 months.
Possibly 4.5.
Possibly 4.5.
But 4 for sure.
Months. Holy shit. So that's pretty crazy that he's going to be gone for that.
Yep. I'm sure you can make a call in here and there on some Sundays maybe.
Update us.
You don't know?
Where I'm going, they've got 3 phones on base.
I know Drex was able to, I think.
Drex went to Wainwright.
Okay.
I'm going to Dundurn.
Dundurn doesn't have phones? No.
Dundurn. Does anyone out there... Because I know we have
Where
some
is Dundurn, actually?
Dundurn is in Saskatchewan.
It's about a half hour south of Saskatoon.
And I imagine, actually, Rancid Girl and probably a couple of the other ones out there know Buck X know where Dundurn is.
Yep. Mm. I've been talking to Rancid Girl. And by the way, the chicken loves goats.
So there you go. Oh, my God.
A little inside joke there.
That is an inside joke.
So butter band
totally
and stuff.
But
I get
case,
that, too. You have to visit our webpage.
Moving right along.
Here we are.
We have Cimmerian.
Hey, Bob.
Welcome to the show. I'm Cimmerian.
Bob from Peru in the house.
Look at my neck.
Look at my neck. It is huge. Sans goiter.
Sans goiter.
Goiter free.
Without
there
goiter.
Is no goiters here. Hello, no deal. Okay, moving right along, we have... The chicken!
Can you smell what the chicken is cooking?
So, in any case, that would be the chicken. Chicken, as a footnote, I know your good friend, Ronan Saryet, he's on some kind of op. Do you have any info on when he might be returning?
It's hard to say, actually. I talked to him over the sat phone last night, and he's right. actually down in New Jersey right now cleaning up the cesspool that's down
that's
there.
That's right.
So he might be a while. Yes.
He was part of that mission,
yes,
wasn't
we had
he?
We had a Jewiger infestation, I understand.
Yeah, and yep. I think they've actually taken some pretty serious hits to their infrastructure, so yeah. He could be a while.
It good. Could be a while.
We're in close contact, and I'll keep you posted for Ronan Saryet's activities.
Okay, excellent. Good enough. We have to. We really need to have Ronan Saryet do a heavy recruiting mission. We need more Ronan out there.
Yep.
Then we have with crazy hair.
Not your craziest.
That's right. But. We have my craziest hair. I went and streaked my hair. Isn't that
ooh,
just fucking
daring.
Crazy? So we have.
He has a job that allows that. And with hey. New hair as well.
With new hair as well.
Sexy goth bang hair.
Very, very vampire. Do some crazy shit. Oh, yeah.
Bite your finger.
Touch yourself.
Look sexy.
Bite your finger.
Oh, yeah, baby. That does it for me.
Okay, so.
There you go. Hello, Raven Lunatic.
And
then we have 200% sexy.
With his
vomit man.
Semi-professional microphone.
With his semi-professional microphone, which you will not melt on the candle. Can you smell?
The candle's burning.
Can you smell?
Can't burning? See anything on the cam. Okay, can you get to my webpage? I guess there is some people who can get to. I'm going to put up the webcam because I thought the webpage is all fucked, but some people can get to it.
Tell
here
me if anybody can
webcam.
Get to the cult webpage because the cult webpage is fucked too. Fucked up like February. It's a big soup sandwich. Just don't worry about it. We'll deal with it later.
We're experiencing technical
we'll tell you all about it in a little bit.
Yes, there was a
there
horrible,
you go.
Horrible problem.
The thing is up now. Have fun. The webcam. Okay, so who's next? It's PVM.
Wait, no.
2000.
No, he's not going to puke yet. We have to go back to super sexy.
She has more to say? What's going on?
No, it's just because you need to zoom in for the new super sexy pose. Do a super sexy. Come on, do a super sexy pose. There you go. Oh, yeah, it's dirty. There you go.
Yum,
okay.
Yum.
Back over. Sex cells. Straight. As, and now to show the contrast, we have the shock. That was so cold.
Shock cut, too.
It's like, oh, God. We have 200%
I'm
sexy.
Bleeding here.
200% sexy projectile vomit man. You know he's what you want. And
I don't feel like making any strange noises right now, so I'm just going to say hello.
And for his last convenient visit,
we have Hungananki.
Probably last, or maybe not.
Ar. I have three words. Is it up?
No.
Is it dead?
Yes.
I didn't go, because I'm a lazy bitch. And I'm not about to drive an hour to press a button, so.
So
I thought I was going to. I thought I had enough dedication, but I don't.
Gargoyle Sim did not. Gargoyle Sim, here's what's happening with the webpage. The Gargoyle Sim needed to go out and press a button on a computer, but he has to drive an hour to get there in order to do this.
And was I going to do this? No.
And
I thought about it. I was going, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
It's an hour each way. That's not
no,
an
no,
hour
no.
Each
well,
way.
If I drive, like, max speed, it's half hour. If I don't, well, then it's like 20, 45
driving,
minutes.
And we'd be there in 10 seconds.
Oh, yeah.
But you would have burned up 8 of your 9 lives.
So look, yeah. Look at all those people in the IRC.
Karma, burn karma.
Karma? Can make a saving throw?
Spend karma.
Look at all those awesome people in the IRC listening to our
show.
Oh
my God, let's go down the list of who's in the IRC.
You guys rock.
We have, of course, Gargoyle Mr. Echo. Always good to see.
Helping us out tonight on the ops here. He's going
to
kick anybody who's a badass.
Oh, yes.
Shit.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
We forgot. Absolutely. We have to go all the way back over. We had Kurt Burt there. Kurt Burt
on the camera,
intro.
And we've neglected him.
And he's got funky eyes.
He's got crazy eyes. Crazy eye. Whoa,
whoa.
Still.
Perfect.
Excellent.
Looks sexy. Okay, in any case, let's go indeed. Yes, koalas.
Koalas.
We need to do is we need to look at the people in the RC we have. Gargoyle Mr. Echo, who is the hard in charge. No,
yeah, he's Mr. Op tonight, kicking ass.
From
in
the icy
IRC.
Chundra of up north, land of the midnight sun. You've got a gargoyle up there with eyes made of steel. Then we come down, we have long-lost friends. Bob from Peru.
I get he got his internet connection back in Peru. I don't know, there's a
and
flood there or something. I don't
back
know.
Up and running around, yes, doing wet works. He's killing kids for $50 a head. Then we have Ephedrine. I don't know if I know you.
This person has been in the IRC for 2 days. I don't know if it's a real person or not.
Aha.
I don't know if they said anything. Who cares?
They're there. Fuck them, they're there. Fault Sequence, good to see you again. And Flesh Tripper Rooster, always solid. Hoongan Midget, good to see you. Infobot, love that Nixter.
Oh, you right, Nixter, you rock.
Nixter has to put his clan name on there. Where's that clan name? I don't see
we
a clan
don't
name
see
there.
See a clan name.
Yeah, I don't see a clan name. MW Radio.
All right.
No deal. Nomad Buck X, good to see you. Glad you're with us. Nomad Infoloop, good to see you. Smokehouse, my main
all
man.
All right, Smokehouse.
OX64. 4, Prophet Rancid Girl, a new prophet.
Yes. Prophet Teener. We got some more about her later.
Prophet Forkay. Fork. Prophet Fork.
Forky.
Spoon, fork. There is no fork.
There is no 4K. Prophet Scribe. Good to hear you, buddy. Good to see you there. And looking forward to the barbecue. And Prophet
Zerstorer,
who's actually, for all intents and purposes, was Prophet Shazbort. So he has changed his name. Now,
I hate that.
Now, what the hell? A little note.
It's so...
No one else is allowed to change their fucking name. I don't do that shit.
It's bloody annoying.
He gets the freebie because he's the first one to do it. Okay. I allow it once. That's it.
Warning,
you're not happy
you.
With your name. Too fucking bad. It's just your cult name. Okay? Live with it. Think real hard before you fill out the form because there's no fucking changing it. In any case, it's annoying when people change their fucking online names. I hate it. Where is that piece of paper sim?
Hoongun Cybertech?
The email. Well, I've got it here. It's right here. You're just checking or?
No, I was just making sure you had it. Okay.
It's right here. This one. It's all cool.
So that's who's all in the
IRC. Did you say everyone? Did you Romulus NR and Prophet Spidey or did you do those ones?
Prophet Spidey? Oh, sorry, Prophet ZZX.
And Hoogan Cybertech also joined us.
Hoogan Cybertech. He just jumped in under the wire. Yep. I left you a phone message, actually, there, Hoogan Cybertech. You probably got it. But, hey, good to see you're in the house. And moving right along, we're going to have,
I got tons of bulletins. Lots of stuff.
Go to the bulletins. What's going on in the world?
Well, first off the top, we're going to have a little interview later with Toren from Darkest of Hillside Thickets, and I'll put it back in the IRC here so you can check out the page while we're talking and you can get up to speed with who this dude is. And he's local here, so it doesn't cost me a dime. So he doesn't need to phone the 1-800 number either. So here it is. Bulletins. Oh, I'd like to thank Bob X. He's our new mirror. I didn't say it last week. I totally forgot. Or maybe it's new. And also Isaac509 at www.sonic.net and headpian at next-net.net. And, okay. We are actually selling some t-shirts now. We have got t-shirts for what for Rant Radio and mugs and mouse pads. I'm going
to
put that.
You knew there had to be something commercial coming.
Oh, yeah, of course. You can't hold out forever, right? So here's the mouse pads, reason, and mugs, and t-shirts.
The only reason most people haven't sold out is because nobody's buying.
That's right. I'm making $1 on each of these, and this is to facilitate us giving away prizes on the show. We haven't done that for a couple weeks, but I'm not making hardly any money on it.
When are a the dollar. Action figure lineup coming out?
You know what? You know what? I found a webpage where you could send them your face, and they'll put your face on an action figure.
Really?
And you can pick from different action figures.
Excellent.
It's
I think
very,
we do
very
that. We
cool
get
action figure.
Action figures for all of us.
That would be so funny.
Gargoyle Sim with keyboard typing action.
What the hell is this? We're, custom action figure?
Yeah, yes. Custom action figures. You send them your face, and they'll put it on an action figure.
No way.
Yeah, I can't remember the link, but I'll find it again.
Yeah, please send
very,
it to
very
me
simple to find.
Something I want to see.
Yeah, somebody has bought a t-shirt. Yeah, Smokehouse has bought a t-shirt. I don't know who else has bought a t-shirt, but because they haven't come up and said it. But I know Smokehouse is, and he's going to send a picture as soon as he gets it. So he can tell me.
Sim, you whore.
I know. I'm cheap. $1.
$1 for
whatever,
what?
That's all I make on a t-shirt.
Those are exorbitant rates for sweatshop workers. You know what those little Kathy Lee Gifford kids are making?
Oh, I know.
That's pretty brutal. As a matter of fact, a lot of people have been on the shirt incident. A lot of people have been asking me. I've gotten a lot of mail about cult shirts where they want clan shirts and they want fucking cool shit. I'm not going to be a bitch like Cimmerian and offer, you know, some white t-shirt which will probably turn into some fucking car rag.
Shut up.
Because it'll wear out, you know, and rip at the shoulders and seams. Actually, what I want, and I'd like to get the input in the MIRC from this, if I could, is I want to set up, instead of t-shirts, because every fucking fag and their seven dogs have goddamn t-shirts, okay? Who doesn't have a fucking t-shirt? What I want to get is I want to get the triple extra large hooded black sweatshirts with the logos on them and, like, put the clan cult logo on the fucking hood.
Oh, yeah, do it full on, right?
And like, so I think that someone would rather pay $55 to get a fucking deadly clan symbol, which I make have designed, have made locally, and then send out?
Yep.
Or how, like, would you pay, like, twice as much to get a cooler fucking shirt, or would you rather just have another t-shirt? Where you can wear your Rant Radio t-shirt, and then you blanket it over top of everything and your clothing with the definitive, and you show up for, like, Beyond Hope 2000 with your cult wear.
Yeah.
You know,
cult wear.
With cult wear. I mean, that'd be so fucking sweet. You know, big Clan Decker fucking logo on the sides of your head.
Shaved in.
Oh, draw it in. Like, semi-permanent tattoos, see if you can get those
right
done
over your
stuff.
Your right eye
it'd be,
or something.
It'd be totally fucking sexy.
Big K right there.
That'd be just porn. Go to the MRC. I want to see what the people are saying about this, because it's a very
la, 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 la.
A hell of a good idea.
Happiness is only a dollar away. Hey, I only have six dogs. nobody said anything.
Okay, well, whatever.
Fuck
that's
you.
That's a stupid idea.
Another 20 seconds.
If anyone is wondering what the hell they're talking, what we're talking about with cult, like a lot of the people who aren't in cult right now and they'd like more information, please email me at kennedy@rantradio.com to see how you can join the winning team.
Or go to cult.rantradio
tomorrow. Or tune into Not tomorrow yet, actually. Tuesday, because I don't go to work tomorrow.
That's what Aaron does, doesn't he?
No, I'm taking over for Aaron. I'm taking over for for somebody else for the rest of the week. At my work.
So am I to understand
that? Shut up about all that. Well, we don't know where any of these servers are.
Will the page be down for another day?
One more day, I'm sorry.
Like after today?
It'll be down tomorrow. It'll be up Tuesday morning.
Tuesday morning.
I'm sorry. I don't feel like driving for an hour to press a button.
That's fine.
I'm really sorry.
So it'll be up on fucking Tuesday.
Yep. Mr. Echo, our awesome man, has made two new intros for the opening page in Rant Radio. One is a Matrix one is a cult-related one. You can get it to it by the homepage, www.rantradio.com. It will be down for some of you out there. Some of you, the old DNS is there if you want to type it in. It's 205, 206, 214, 247. There
it's
you go.
All
if you're, if you're, if you're internet savvy, you can do that. About the new mirror, Bob X says, I can mention briefly, and who the hell is Bob X? Netizens had been asking themselves for this for a long time. It'll cause more mayhem. I like mayhem and chaos. I build automated advertising systems. I left my name everywhere. Ha ha ha. It doesn't make sense, but he gives us bandwidth.
That's okay.
It's all good.
We all like Bob X.
We all like Bob X.
Bob X is good.
He's the guy who gave us 1,024 slots for listeners. Like, big bandwidth.
Is that legit or what?
Oh, it's totally legit. I've logged in. It's really fast. I don't know. I don't know if it can fill up that high, but hey, that's all good. We'll give it a good shot at it. M Grind.
Can fill his budget or something?
Some of these people, that's what they need to do. They need to justify their budget for the big bandwidth. See, we're maxed out. We need more, actually.
Hey, marketing flack, look at the pretty graph.
Yeah, look how high it is.
We'll give slots away to this little pissant radio station on the internet. Yeah, that's okay. Wait a minute. They're growing.
Finally, a use for PowerPoint.
No kidding, eh?
That's right. I've got some comments from some listeners. I don't know if I've ever said these before. M. Grinder has sent in, I make it a habit of starting the day with some Rant Radio. Nothing to wake you up like Sean the fucking man Kennedy. Keep up the good work.
Yay. I feel so special.
Swell.
No, I'm sorry. Cult. Like, you should read some of the cult submissions I get. That's
oh,
swell.
Yeah. Shasport says, I don't have time. There's only time to kill. Okay, I'll calm down now. You know, it's really hard to miss a show. I don't get that extra rebellious boost from Sean K's brutal ranting. That extra dry heave over the toilet after a gross hospital story or whatever the hell I get from funny shit. Right. My therapist says it's from all the cocaine I did back in the 60s, but I told him I quit coke after my lobotomy. Yeah, I'm going to go eat something. Never drink gasoline on an empty stomach. Cue up gasoline by MDFMK. Perfect.
I see.
Psyop 312. Kennedy is too much. Tell Kennedy he got me on the right track now. Even my father, who's 56, likes his rants.
Woohoo!
Okay, so we're going to do the interview with Toren from Dark Sales. I think it's in a minute. I'm just going to cue up a little thing from him to give you a little taste. Not a full song, sort of an intro song. As soon as I find it, somebody else say something for a while.
All right, I'm going to start talking.
Talk about cult or something.
In the cult news, once again, because Sim is a weak bag of shit, the cult page will not be up until Tuesday.
Shut up. Weak bag of shit.
So it's totally not my fault. I have all kinds of content, but of course, I am being stopped by my good friend who has put this rather large blade through my spinal column. As soon as I can writhe around on my back and pull this knife out of my back, I will be sure to post to the page as I have a ton of shit.
And give the blade back to him who stabbed.
And he who
hence stabbed, will be receiving blades smitely. However, in all honesty, I mean, you can't really blame the guy. I mean, who wants to drive 2 hours just to push a button? I mean, I do it for him, but I mean, obviously, it's all kinds of it's all kinds of weakness, you know. Maybe I'll remember this next time his car breaks down and he needs a ride somewhere. Yeah.
Bring it all up.
In any case, that's okay, though. That's okay.
What the fuck is it?
What we can do, though, is if you are interested in learning a little bit more about cult, is seriously what we're about, what the whole idea of organizing the internet subculture and counterculture, email me at kennedy@rantradio.com, and we'll be able to sort you right out. How are we doing on that tune there, Sim? How are we coming? Are you finding anything? Do you know where anything is in your computer? You know, there's a handy feature in Windows called Find.
It's called.
It's under the Start menu, little button, lower left hand.
Okay.
We got some new promos.
But I can't. I have to hear it. Okay, this is it, I think.
You think so?
So
wow.
I'm going to play it. If it's not, then
wow,
too
technical
fucking bad.
Competence at its finest.
There we go. It's all fucking porn.
That's right. So here's a little snippet from Darkest Hillside Thickets off their new album. Here we go, I think. Maybe. I'm going to turn up the volume here.
Yeah, blah.
We're all professional here.
Here's hoping.
Blah, blah.
Don't sound
fucking
so overconfident.
Blah. Yeah, just play the guitar. J-Band is born. So we are going to go and we are going to be contacting Toren from the Darkest of the Hillside Thickets.
Or something like that.
Or something like that. Or if he's even home.
Oh, he's home.
He could
be home.
Humping herpes.
Hello, Toren.
Yes.
This is James.
Hello, James.
Or Cimmerian, actually. Oops, I've given away my secret identity.
You are off my commando team.
So how are you doing tonight?
I'm doing fine.
Excellent. So we have a lot of weird and strange questions lined up for you.
Oh, well, I hope I can answer them.
Oh, I hope so, too. Otherwise, it'd be a very boring interview.
Can you take a moment and stop humping all your Cthulian groupies and speak with us?
I can do both at the same time.
There you go!
All right.
That's multitasking!
There's a man with tendrils. All right.
But the scales are so chafy.
Okay. Hello, Toren. Welcome to Rant Radio.
Hello, I'm happy to be at Rant Radio.
Excellent.
I'm just so gutted.
Day, 7 days a week.
You listen to us all the time. In your car, all the time. I just know it. Yeah.
He just records it during the night so he can get it during the day.
Okay. Could you tell us about yourself and your band and give us all your pertinent statistics to our listeners so we don't have to ask all these boring, silly little questions? I know it's boring, but we have to get it out in the open just to introduce them. It's who you are.
Okay, well, I'm the lead singer and, I don't know, creative director, let's say, for the Cthulhu punk band, The Darkest of the Hillside Thickets.
Excellent. That's about it for that. Okay. I've got this on my palm.
Oh, no, please.
Okay. What did you have for breakfast this morning?
This morning I actually had my second favorite cereal, Reese's Peanut Butter Puffs.
Excellent.
Sweet.
Sugar, nature's natural high.
What's the first favorite?
The first favorite has to be Count Chocula.
Yee-hoo!
Of course.
Better known as sugar-coated chocolate puffs.
The reason I ask this is I know you're very into the whole Saturday morning cartoon thing.
That's very true.
And maybe you can describe how this ties in with your music.
I didn't know it did.
Sure it does. You have that song, the superhero song. Come on.
Oh, that's right. Power Up.
Power Up, right.
So in fact, I just uploaded to Napster today.
Oh, excellent.
Yeah.
I know I have all of your songs, some of your songs, on Nutella. So people, if they search for Darkest Hillside Thickets,
oh, really?
They may be able to find it if I'm online.
Nutella.
Nutella, have you heard of that?
Oh, I haven't heard of that.
Okay, get Nutella. Okay.
Nutella is mighty.
He can go on Tuesday. You'll be able to go to the cult webpage and find a link to it there.
Right. We'll do whatever you guys tell me to do.
Yeah, you better.
That's a good answer.
Okay.
Yeah, so Power Up. It's about superheroes.
That's right. So you like superheroes. That's sort of how it ties in.
Right, and it's the second... I think it's going to be the second song that we do a video for the new album.
Really?
Yeah, we're going to make some new superhero costumes and go out in the town.
Excellent. So what's the first video?
That would probably be 20 minutes of Oxygen.
Oh, sweet.
I have an actual question for Toren.
Okay.
Quite often a lot of musical people have a desire, and they have a lot of music, and quite often artists enjoy one of their songs more than any of their fans do. Like, they feel that that is their favorite song, that's their best song, but all their fans wind up liking another song, and they're like, God, that's not the good song, you should like this song. Why do you like that song? What is your personal favorite song that the band has done?
In the history of time?
Yeah.
That's a good question.
Because there's a lot of songs.
I have a lot of good questions. I'll be hitting you with those, and we might do some Cthulhu trivia later.
More than 50, actually. For the longest time, it used to be Chunk.
Oh, yeah.
Which is nobody's favorite song.
It's okay.
Right now, my favorite is probably going to be Frogstar.
That's a cool song, too. That's one of the new ones.
Yeah, it's heavy and rumbling, and it's way out there.
That's pretty decent. What's the name of that tune? My personal favorite of your work that you've done that I enjoy is the what is that? I can't even remember the title of it. It's the one with the bombers and they drop Shoggoths. Shoggoths away.
That's right.
That's probably one of my favorite.
Very powerful.
Oh
song.
Yeah, I mean, it's. I think we should. Do we have that able to be queued?
Eventually, we'll queue that. I've got some more questions first.
Okay.
That's a very popular one, actually.
Oh yeah.
In fact, I put a questionnaire online. I don't remember the address for it.
Yes, that's right.
And that's important, those address things.
It listed the entire Thickets repertoire, and I think that was the one that came ahead of all the other ones.
Oh, this was a different questionnaire.
Yeah, it's the Thickets questionnaire.
Ah.
Okay.
Okay, next question. Because it is your brother, Merrick, that sings backup vocals on the Thickets,
right.
The vocals live sound like there's two of you on stage. Has Merrick ever filled in for you for a whole gig?
No, he is not.
Is he willing to?
I don't know if he would. He probably wouldn't be.
Really?
Probably not. Why? Are you going to have something done to me?
Just in case you get taken out or, can't perform. Right. No. I was just wondering.
Something in my cereal.
drowning in your cereal face down. Has he ever been in another band, or is this his first band?
He's been in a couple bands. His last band was called Draining Faces.
Really?
Yes, and they were on...
I think it's a Skinny Puppy song.
...put out a CD called Fraser Valley Champions, which I still have a few copies of.
Draining Faces with a Skinny Puppy song?
It seems to remind me of a title. Something similar, I think. Yeah.
Okay, one of our people here thinks it might have been.
That's crazy talk.
That's crazy talk. can you maybe describe for our listeners what you guys look like on stage?
Well, it kind of varies from night to night.
True.
The last show, let me think now. I was had a costume, which was basically a giant eyeball.
Really?
Yes, a giant eyeball with a bunch of veins hanging down over my body.
Oh,
giant eyeball was over top of my head on a helmet. And the veins draped down over the rest of my body. And I think the rest of the guys were just hazmat.
Hazmat, yeah.
Yeah.
The regular kind of spacey-looking
That's right.
uniforms, yeah.
It varies from show to show.
Depending on your mood.
That's right.
Of course, the drummer sheds his costume immediately.
Well, and so does the bass player quite often.
Yeah, it gets kind of hot.
That's right.
Do you find that the costumes are intimidating to record company execs?
Who cares?
And how much would it take for you guys to sell out and drop the costumes and sing about sex, money, and how fast your car goes?
It all depends on how much money we're talking about.
Honesty.
And the chicks.
And the chicks, yeah.
Right. And how hot the chicks are, baby.
Can you tell our audience who H.P. Lovecraft is?
I can, and what's more, I will.
Excellent.
He was an author of weird fiction.
Mm-hmm.
Who had his work published mainly in pulp magazines in the 20s and 30s.
Yeah.
And he wrote about strange gods and the madness of the universe and all that kind of crazy stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And we love it. And so a lot of our songs are inspired by his writing.
Excellent.
Cool.
And what is Spaceship Zero?
Spaceship Zero is many things to many people. For us, it's the soundtrack to the movie. That's coming out.
Yeah.
And it's not exactly a soundtrack. Most of it is inspired by the various mythos of Spaceship Zero.
Right. And how does that tie in with you guys?
How does it tie in with us?
Yeah.
Well, it's exciting. It's an exciting time to be a Thicket.
Yep.
Because there's many facets to Spaceship Zero. We're also publishing a role-playing game.
Right.
Spaceship Zero.
Isn't that out already? Or was that a beta you guys were playing a little while ago?
We're working on it.
Yeah. Still in testing phase.
That's right.
Right.
And, what else? Well, there's the website, of course, www.spaceshipzero.com.
That's right.
That everyone should check out.
You can hear track one off your new album.
That's right, exactly.
And we just played that before we phoned you up.
Oh, marvelous.
Yes. Anybody else have any questions? I've run out.
Actually, I've got one.
Okay, chicken.
This is a very cliche question, but I want to know what the Darkest of the Hillside Thickets draws off of her musical influences, and what do these guys listen to?
Ah.
I'm sorry, I didn't catch that last part.
What do you guys listen to? And, of course, what are your influences?
Well, they're one and the same, I think.
Yeah.
Except for I listen to some classical music. That doesn't really influence me.
I don't see it in the music, really.
No means no. Queens of the Stone Age, they're big. You know, stuff like Helmet and Tad and heavy, mainly heavy stuff.
Right.
Any Slipknot?
Heavy, but melodic.
Right, yeah. A lot of melody in your music. Of course, it ties in with pop punk, right?
I guess it does.
Powerful, yet melodious.
It's always been hard to describe.
That's right. You keep asking me. I don't know how to describe you. I don't know what you sound like.
Right. And I keep getting circuitous answers.
Anybody else have any questions?
I have some Cthulhu trivia for our number one Cthulhu guy here. So these are just some simple questions just to see how Cthulhu literate he really is.
Oh, no. I didn't know there was going to be a test.
Ah-ha-ha!
I would have boned up.
Oh, well, I won't hit you with anything too crazy. Don't worry about it. Okay, for one thing, where are the Mountains of Madness?
The Mountains of Madness are in Antarctica.
That is correct, sir. Yes.
Ding, ding.
Okay, moving right along. What is Ryla?
You mean Relia.
Oh, okay. Oh. Sorry about that Sumerian pronunciation here. We'll have to actually go for that. But anyway.
Relia is the sunken continent / city that Cthulhu lives at the bottom of the Pacific Ocean.
I see. And where? And do you have a grid for that? Or?
What?
Is this going to be all geography questions?
No, not exactly. If I was being attacked by an elder god,
yes,
and I had to have an artifact to hold them at bay, what artifact would I want to have?
Well, I tend towards you have no chance in hell. if you did have to have something, I would probably go with an elder sign.
Ah. What's another? And what are the elder signs usually placed upon?
What are they placed upon?
Yes.
I'm getting kind of obscure on you. I have a coffee mug at home that I have an elder sign on.
Pardon me?
I have a coffee mug at home that I have an elder sign on.
Stay away! I have my coffee mug.
He's totally right. I'm thinking about star stones is what I'm thinking about.
Oh, a star stone of Nar.
Yeah.
They're usually placed on like amulets or something, as far as I know. But whew. Can be put on anything.
What advice could you give to our listeners if they think they're being stalked by Cthulian entities?
Embrace Jesus Christ. Only him will you have the life everlasting.
Okay, you fucking rule. That's about all we've got from this end of the table.
So, wrapping up, anything you want to say that about the Darkest of the Hillside Thickets that would make people want to listen to you?
Make them want to listen to us?
Yeah. Give them a reason.
Oh, gosh, we're just so exciting.
Matt, you're hung like a bull moose.
If you like crazy, nutty, wacky monster music.
That's right.
Then we're your number one band.
And you got to see them
number
live.
One and only.
Yeah, that's what I've heard from a lot of people.
And it's another experience
and
live.
If people don't listen to them, then dark gods will slither up from the netherworld and eat them alive.
That's a pretty good reason, too.
It's your first line of protection, is listening to the band.
First line of defense.
That's
only the beginning, my friends. The beginning.
James, another question of why is it that...
Speak up.
Why is it that it's quite funny meeting you in person? You're quite a quiet character, but on the stage you're a nut.
Well, it's always the quiet ones, isn't it?
That's right. They go out and kill hordes of people at the post office.
Yes.
Plus, it's the copious amounts of drugs they take before each and every show.
It's not drugs. It's space mead, and there's a perfectly good reason for it.
You don't want to hear what's on my mind when I'm not singing about Cthulhu.
We don't want to venture into that realm, do we?
Exactly.
So we're going to play the math song.
Oh, great.
It's recorded live, of course, because, well, we don't have a recording of it yet.
No, but the new album should be out in about 4 weeks.
It's a continual...
4 weeks ago.
And 4 weeks before that. It's a continual 4 weeks. You need a time machine to get it, don't you?
I think so. We're working on that.
It'll come as soon as...
It'll be 4 weeks until we get the time machine ready,
as soon as you get the time machine ready, too. Okay, so I really, like the math song, and I think our...
I know a member of the great race of Yith who claims to be able to actually get that recording.
There we go.
Fine, to do someone in the future.
So we think that, I think the math song will be very appropriate for our listeners. They're all computer geeks, right?
Right.
And it's a very ironic song. It's a love song,
actually.
To the
lowest common denominator, and that's computer geeks.
I have one last question. What is the answer to the math song?
I can't tell you that.
You have to write it down, right, Toren?
Well, it's the actual formula will be in the liner notes.
Oh, come on. You can tell us because we're your
listeners. No. Because the first person who sends in the answer is going to get a big surprise.
Big surprise.
He gives kick-ass surprises. We got a Spidey tape.
That was CD. Awesome, that Spider-Man CD. That was so kick-ass.
Oh, well, yeah.
There's like 80 tracks or something.
I know.
You haven't done anything nasty like slip a page from the Book of Glacky in there, have you?
Oh.
I'm not at liberty to say.
That'd be great. Everyone opens up, reads the lyric sheets, and they all go insane. They lose 20 sand points like right fucking now.
Sing along to your destruction.
Right on. Spark it up.
So can you say something degrading or gratuitous about Rant Radio so we can use it at our will?
Oh, geez, sure. I'm a thicket, and I love Rant Radio. It blows my mind.
That's great. Woo-hoo! Thank you for the interview.
You're welcome.
And we're going to play the math song.
Okay.
Thanks a lot, Tor.
Say what the hell.
Say what the hell, and we'll hang up on you.
What the hell.
All right. That was Toren. And here is the math song recorded live at Area 51 last year. Here it is.
Back in action.
Oh, we're not back.
Ah, Lani, this is What the Hell Show. Yeah, rot your brain.
Oh, I see what's going on. We missed it.
And now, back to the What the Hell Show on Rant Radio.
We missed it. Oh, in the house. I'll play them for them after. That was okay. a new promo by Raven Lunatic. That Scottish one. And the back one. Both of them, we altered her voice.
Sweet.
Of course.
Fall 2 against Sean, if you're listening, two papers are running my story. Is that after? I will talk about his story in just a few moments when we get to the...
That was Star Wars in that song, too. They like Star Wars.
Into the section Sort Yourself Out, where we read about advice. But I am very, very happy to hear about that. And we'll talk more about that later. However, right now, we're going to talk about some submissions, which is stuff that people have sent in.
Specifically...
We like it when people send in rants. We've got a lot of rants that have been sent in.
Oh, yeah.
But
send in more rants. If you got a beef, send it in.
And
upload it.
Not only will we play it on the show, but we'll put it in rotation on the station. Now, this is something, first of all, what I'd like to play is something that's not going to be going into rotation on the station because it doesn't fit with station format. But it's very, very rarely we get music. What's that?
Should we do another song right away?
Do it in cult?
Yeah.
Okay.
I want to do Capone X's first.
But, okay.
Because we just heard two songs.
They just hear two songs.
Yeah.
Because, you know, whatever. Anyway, but we're going to talk about some submissions. Let's go through some submissions. We got some good submissions here. What else we got as a submission?
Oh, we just got Capone X's thing he sent in.
Okay.
No other rants. There's no other rants that people sent in.
That's okay, though.
We got one. So we're going to play. This is from Capone X. Is he in the house tonight?
Gargoyle Capone X? No, probably not. But
he might have been on the net split. So,
yeah, he's one of our most dedicated guys. So
but if he's not here, somebody tell him that we did play it. So here's Capone X, and it's on personal responsibility. And if you want to send some in, just upload them to ftp.rantradio.com in the incoming folder. Here's Capone X.
Okay, I've noticed something all around me, and I'm sure you have too, and I'm sick to death of it. It's quite simple, really. People refuse to take responsibility for their actions. Can't afford to pay your bills after spending $100 on just shit at the mall?
Oh, but I just had to have new clothes.
Got your license pulled after driving all over the road shit-faced?
Oh, that cop was picking on me.
Busted by your significant other while fucking around on them?
My mate is so nosy.
Aw, poor you. You're a victim. Everyone's a fucking victim. Just go on international television on Sally or Oprah or whoever it is this week that's in and cry victim. Everyone will give you sympathy. Fuck that. If you're going to be stupid and do something that you just know you shouldn't do, at least have the fucking guts to stand up and say, yeah, I'm a goddamn moron. I shouldn't have done that. Quit being a fucking victim and take responsibility for your actions. Or as they say here in the South, get off the cross, Mary. Someone else needs the wood. I'm Capone X and the Gargoyles are watching.
Thank you for listening to the What the Hell Show on Rant Radio.
That was Raven Lunatic as well.
All right, so that's right. That's pretty much it for the submissions. But right about now, I think there's an add-in that we're going to be doing. Should we move on to brainwashing or what? It's that special time in Sim's life.
Somebody make a decision.
Okay, let's play the brainwashing intro. Brainwashing, by the way, just to bring you people up to speed. Oh, fuck it, play the brainwashing intro.
Like I have it on hand. Bring it right on me.
What the hell?
Where the hell is it?
Where the hell is it? It's like the one that Smokehouse did, you fucking junkie.
Oh, maybe it's in
Put the crack pipe down.
Damn it, there's so many things, okay?
Stop sucking on the glass
deck.
Oh,
I know.
There we go. Oh,
profits? No, that's not it.
We're all fucked up like February. Where is it? Where?
Are you really fucked up?
Where is it? Oh, no. Smokehouse, where is it?
We
suck. Not Smokehouse's fault.
We totally sucked.
Sucks tonight.
Well, find it. We need it.
Blame Cimmerian.
Blame Cimmerian.
With his beady little eyes and his flappy little head. Blame Cimmerian.
Downloads, would it be something that he just sent?
Could be.
What's going on is, as he's looking desperately for this...
There we go.
Brainwashing intro one, that's not the one that Smokehouse did, though.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Is it a brainwashing intro? Yes? Will it work?
No,
yes,
it won't. It. Shut the fuck up. No, because he made this fucking intro, and he said...
I don't have it.
By the,
what's it called?
Yeah, you do.
It's called Smokehouse Brainwashing, I think. Or something. Just go brainwashing and list everything.
See, nobody has a fucking answer.
Called fucking brainwashing. In any case, what's going to be happening is, although Brainwashing was a downloadable magazine, we're not going to be able to do that every goddamn 2 weeks because, well, I have a page, when it works, that I have to throw up onto the whole deal here. And so what we're going to be doing is we're going to be doing brainwashing information as the as part of What the Hell. So okay. At 10 o'clock every night, we're going to be doing brainwashing intro. So let's have an intro.
Okay.
Fuck it. Here's an intro.
The following program is closed captioned for the thinking impaired.
Rolling.
The movie will begin in 5 moments, the mindless voice announced. All those unseated will await the next show. The program for this evening is not new. You have seen this entertainment through and through. You've seen your birth, your life, and death. You might recall all of the rest. Did you have a good world when you died? Enough to base a movie on?
Is everybody in? Everybody in? Ceremony is about to begin.
Brainwashing. Cult, yes, the power that is.
Nail it down, strap it down, or they'll grab it if they can't take it home. They'll burn it if they can't burn it. They'll fuck it.
I am the fucking man. My name is Sean Kennedy, and I judge.
All right.
All right. So that was basically the intro that Smokehouse did. Absolutely amazing. Nomad Smokehouse, thanks ever so much. That will be the new intro that we use until we get, well, a better intro that somebody else makes and throws it up, because it'd be really cool to just have a big fistful of intros that we use. That way, every week would be different. Right off the top, let's talk about new members to the cult. Always good. We got to keep the virus growing. That would be Nomad Infaloop. Very good to see you. Prophet Spider, the Prophet Rancid Girl, which we'll be talking about momentarily. And we got a vampire this week. Yes, it's true. We have our very first vampire called Fistin, as in Fist in the Wall. So it's very, very cool. He's out of California. Good guy. I haven't updated the page yet because the page is down, but it will be up on Tuesday, so we'll be able to go from there. Also, we have Nomad Buck X, and we have Prophet Diener and Prophet Quoth, who is also our second female. I had two females join this week, Prophet Rancid Girl and Prophet Quoth. Now, moving right along for poignant news is because Prophet Quoth actually, or not Prophet Quoth, Prophet Rancid Girl actually sent in a song that she did. Now, this is not something that would be generally played on Rant Radio, because it is not heavy, it is not industrial, but I think it's pretty fucking cool that it's something that she did, and would be kind of neat to listen to. So if you guys are going to sit there and just flame the shit out of it, why don't you sing something and send it in, and I'll fucking flame the shit out of you, because for someone just fucking screwing around with a microphone and a couple of guitars, I think this kicks pretty good ass, and it's neat, it's cool to see something different, and it beats the hell out of Sarah McLachlan as far as I'm concerned, so let's spark it up.
Okay.
I'm Raven Lunatic. Now I listen to What the Hell, because I have to.
Pain inside.
but we're trying to come up with a name for a toy.
Mrs. Fun?
Not bad.
Fun?
Ralph, there are no right or wrong answers, but if you don't pipe down, I'm giving you an F.
The before teacher yelled at me, too.
No one's yelling. We're just brainstorming names. Lisa, any ideas?
Oh, name with fun, fungus, funzo, Attila the Fun.
Lisa, are you doing math?
Just a few Venn diagrams.
There's more under her chair.
All right,
we're back.
That fucking song ruled.
I thought it was pretty cool. I mean,
it's called Rape My World?
Yeah, Rape My World, which is just so perfect that it's called Rape My World, and it's like, you know, all
la,
mellow,
la, la,
la, la, la. If we put some echo effects in there and made it kind of delirium and shit, that'd be, like, really sweet. So it was very, very cool. And
I want to hear a Slipknot cover of that song, actually.
Yes, I'd like to see Slipknot and By God 20. They could do a cover. Yep. Korn, some Limp Bizkit could do that. Cannibal Corpse does a cover, I think, of that.
MDFMK remix.
Sasha remix. Yeah,
Sasha remix.
Could do that. And Rammstein, I think, has a German version of that that they've put out as well.
I think it's called Du Hast Me or something like that.
Du Hast Me. I've got a very scary story. It's Finding the Guilty Party by Process of Elimination. 600 give DNA swabs, man facing rape rap. Sydney, Australia. Oh, the great Australians and their
really
laws.
Oh, they're really open-minded down there, too. Yeah, they're really good.
A man has been charged with the brutal rape of a 91-year-old woman, a crime that has caused police to conduct DNA tests for almost every male in the small Australian town of Weewa.
Weewa?
Weewa.
Police refuse to say whether...
I'm sorry, if I lived in Weewa, I'd probably rape some 91-year-old chick, too, because I'd probably want to die. But...
Police launched the mass testing plan so they can compare samples from volunteers to DNA material found at the scene of the crime.
Why would you volunteer if...
Only about 20 men in the cotton-growing town refused to give samples in Weewa, 500 kilometers north of Sydney. Wow.
So, wow, you have 1 in 20 chance. What the fuck are you going to do then? What, do you force take their DNA or what? So a bunch of guys jerked off in a jar. Big fucking deal.
Yeah, but all their DNA is down, and the police have got all their information.
Yeah, that's the problem. They now have it all on record.
Yeah, so, wow.
Everybody.
Dang, I can't rape any more 91 women, but she had the body of a 7-year-old.
DNA, they can pick up your DNA from anything. If you did anything, I'll just go swab. Oh, it's Sean.
Oh, that's true.
Well, Sean,
what were you doing
you're dead.
Weewa?
Well, they
stay
know
out
I
of Weewa.
I carved my fucking name in her face.
I'm not so disturbed about the fact that the police have this information and that they can catch criminals.
Is that all these people volunteered?
Well, not even that. It's the fact that what happens when
you
somebody
need a microphone,
gets that
man.
Information... What happens when somebody gets that information or breaks into the computer database, the cop's database, and changes some of it?
Yeah, that's
flips
right.
Flips two people? That DNA evidence is like considered the close-all, end-all of a court case.
That's pretty much true, yeah.
I've got some personal safety tips from The Onion here.
Personal safety tips? These are mighty.
Oh, I love these rundown things. I've checked off the good ones, so I don't have to read through 50 of them. In today's crime-ridden world, personal safety is more important than ever. Here are some tips to protect yourself. Pickpockets thrive in large, crowded areas where they can blend in and strike unnoticed. Stick to dark, isolated alleyways. Remember, you can't get attacked by anyone if you preemptively attack everyone you encounter first.
Absolutely.
that's what Roland Saryet lives like.
Oh. Yeah, a best defense is good offense. Carry your shovel.
Stick them first, ask questions later. Always check the back seat before getting in your car. If a menacing-looking man is hiding there, get a friend or coworker to accompany you. When venturing out in public, cover your genitals with both hands while scurrying fervently place to place. Carry mace with you at all times. This medieval spiked ball is ideal for fending off would-be attackers.
Absolutely.
If forced to fight, use Tai Chi slowly to defeat your enemy slowly. If you go jogging, wear sweatpants that say, "Do not rape" on the ass and crotch. If threatened by a carnivorous space alien, stand next to the guy featured most prominently on the movie poster. Keep in mind that it's hard to rob somebody who has taken the precautionary measure of setting himself or herself ablaze.
Yes, the Buddhist approach. Very, very solid.
And according to the NRA, the best form of personal protection is to be in possession of a loaded firearms at all times. To ensure your personal safety, stay the hell away from NRA members.
They don't say shit about cult members, because we preemptively knife those fuckers too. But in any case, moving right along. What else we got there? What else? How about we jump a little bit ahead here, because it's 10:12, but that's okay.
Yep.
We are going to do Sort Yourself Out. Now, to start off with Sort Yourself Out, we had a very interesting thing from Fault Sequence. Can I get that email?
Sure.
Now, I got this email earlier this week, and this is really serious, guys. Like, this is fucking something else. I'm going to read this out. And apparently, Fault Sequence was talking to me about this. But anyway, I'll read it off here. Hey, Sean K. I hope you don't mind me doing this, Fault Sequence, because here we fucking go. Hey, Sean K. First off, awesome website. Congrats to Enki on it. And it would be up if Cimmerian pressed the fucking button. I recently took a job at a web development firm, so if you should need it, I can do some more on Rant Radio site, blah, 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 blah. The real reason for this letter is to tell you what's been happening at school. Read daycare. Lately, my school consists of a large number of white upper-middle-class jocks and preps. Not to stereotype, but it's a lot like Columbine was. Anyway... Foreshadowing. Anyway, someone took the liberty to exercise some free thought and published anonymously a pamphlet which talked about cliques, jocks, preps, rights, etc. No threats, just that's all it was. He published 65 copies and distributed them. This person managed to land himself 10 days suspension, and they're threatening to expel him for writing a pamphlet for exercising free speech. A direct quote from the principal sums it up well. When you come here, you don't have First Amendment rights. This is what the principal said, apparently, in front of fucking...
A bunch of people,
and they have it quoted. Now, he says, you're a reasonable guy. You manage to see things as they are. I'm asking for your advice. What, do we protest this? Do we publish more copies of the text? Or do I tell myself, fuck it, and I'm looking out for my ass and waiting for the remaining of the year? There's lots of people backing, and whatever my action I decide to take, I'm going to go down hard for, maybe harder than my friend. Fault Sequence. Well, Fault Sequence, as I instructed to Fault Sequence, I said that the number one thing that he should do is he should scream, victim. Use the papers on your fucking side. Sit back and go, hey, motherfucker, what do you mean I don't have rights? And the school board's looking for this kind of shit right now, especially after the Columbine, and then there's kids knifing each other in school, and they're all trying to play this. So if you look like a kid who's just trying to, I'm trying to stand up for my rights, I'm just trying to stand up for what I'm doing, and look at this evil teacher, he touched me in my bad spot, and all the fucking rest of it. You can totally have this guy's hand on a stick. And apparently, we have had... Don't deploy thermite on the principal's car.
effective, but no.
Effective, thermite. But no. First, we must destroy his career. Then we will move in on him. What has happened is he took the advice, and now two local newspapers are running the story. That's what he spoke about earlier. Two local newspapers are running the story, and as that progresses... It seems that the advice I gave him, what a surprise, fucking panned out.
Wow, okay. Excellent.
So it looks like he might completely fuck this guy around, which I think is extremely sweet. Like how...
Well, the quote cinches it.
Like,
I mean,
when you come here, you don't have First Amendment rights. Wait, I'm not an American if I go to this high school.
Yep.
Boom! I tell you what, why don't you take all of this rope, wrap it completely around your head, and fucking go jump off of something, you moron. I mean, how crazy is that? So it's very, very cool. That has happened. If you have any advice that you'd like to, if you have any questions or something that's happening in your life that you would like to, call in with and ask for advice on, or if you just want to go off about something that's happening in your life and you'd like to get some insight on it. I mean, we make a lot of jokes here about burning shit down and blowing shit up, but we don't have the numbers to effectively execute that yet. So in the meantime, in between time, what we're going to do...
Ronan Saryet's very taxed.
...is we're going to be handing out, practical advice... And things in your life that, we'll give it to you fucking straight, rather than, well, you should talk to an adult about it, and find someone you trust
okay.
And confident. And
go to a counselor or a teacher. Wait.
That works real well. I had a great experience with, when I talked to my counselor in high school, they tried to put me in a fucking nut hatch. But, they thought I was violent. Who knew?
Do you want to open up the phone line, see if anybody out there has
some stuff? Sure. Why don't we open up the phone lines?
Anybody has
anybody
anything
need
to
advice?
Ask?
This section of the show, once we get a... an intro for it. If anyone wants
We got a phone lines intro, so we're going to do that.
Oh, sure. And if anyone
give
wants
them the
to
number.
Make another intro. Yeah.
We'll make an intro later, but sure. This will do for now for
sure.
The phones.
Right
okay.
On. So call in now if you want to rant, go off, fucking talk to us, say
one,
suck my cock,
1-877-729-7268.
Welcome. 1-877-729-7268.
Have you got something you've got to get off your chest? You can call the What the Hell Show toll free right now at 1-877-SAY-RAND or 1-877-729-7268, baby.
Welcome. Okay, so we're back on. Anybody want to call? Nobody call. In the meantime, in between time, vault sequence. If you're listening, please call in. I'd like to get a live update from you. It's a 1-800 number, so there's no charge on the call. It's free. Call you. Fuck. I sent you the email. Fucking call me. We have some dead air we got to fill here. Come on. Jesus Christ.
Just high school guidance counselor.
There we go. Oh,
never mind.
Is that two? That's full blown.
I'll answer it. Who is it?
Hi, you're on Rant Radio. Who is this?
Lieutenant Major Zombie.
And you phoned the regular number? Why didn't you phone the 1-800 number?
Nobody ever told me the 1-800 number.
Okay, well, it's your dime. Do you want to phone back or... Okay, we'll just keep you on. Here's Sean.
Okay, so for once in your life, you've called in at the correct time to call. What would you have to say?
I suck. No.
You suck.
No.
No, I have a sucky phone connection. I need to get cable.
Okay, so thank you very much. Yes, it's absolutely.
He's still on. He's still on.
That, what
that's
is,
good. That's good. You
that's
have a sucky
good.
Connection.
So everyone in the world needs
he needs
to
advice
understand
on...
that Lieutenant Major Zombie had a sucky phone connection.
And, Sean,
and for the love of God, don't do drugs.
Yeah.
Don't do drugs.
And remember, inbreeding hurts everyone. You know?
What can he do about this faulty, horrible connection he has, Sean? He needs advice.
He needs advice. Your advice on the phone connection.
First of all, get the hell away from AOL.
Yeah, first of all, get away from AOL. If you need to get a better phone connection, I would say move. To someplace where they have a better phone connection. That's very, very good.
Who is supposed to call? Anyone's supposed to call. You have
anyone's supposed to call.
You have
I would like Vault Sequence to call.
You have
because,
questions. You have...
Yeah, I'd like to get an actual an audio follow-up on that. But if anyone can call, right now, call the number 1-877-SAY-RANT, and we'll get it up. We'll get it happening. And you can just call in right now. So there's a lot of people out there who... you know, would have something to say, would have something to go off about. Anybody calling you, bunch of freaks? Come on, you
okay,
fuckers.
News time, then.
News time.
Too bad
Fine,
for
Fine, while we're waiting for you, we'll go to some news. What do we got? Oh, we got somebody else here.
There we go, on
there
the 1-800 number.
Right, press speaker.
Yep.
You're on live on Rant Radio. Who's this?
Yeah, this is Hope.
Hope.
Hi, Hope. We haven't seen you in here before. How you doing?
Hmm. All right, I was just getting your guys' channel. Wanted to tell you guys something.
What's that?
That hold on, sorry, my phone's all shitty. What was it? That little speech about how people are bitching.
Oh yeah, how people are bitching about things that aren't their fault.
That was fucking awesome.
Yes, that.
Yes,
was
it was.
Capone X. He's a very, very solid guy. Where are you calling from? Just a general city.
Bloomington, Minnesota.
Bloomington, Minnesota. How are things down in Bloomington?
All right, it's fucking freezing. Where's this shoutcaster from?
Where is Shoutcast from?
I don't know where Shoutcast is.
Where are you guys doing this from?
Oh, we're doing it from Langley, British Columbia, Canada. The hacker heaven, don't you know? We're not able to be touched by things like, the
FBI?
Well, most of the American laws on broadcasting, where...
We're actually allowed to broadcast anything we want, which takes the fun out of it, but, you know...
So, we are pirate because we wear a lot of eye patches and little skulls and crossbones, but other than that, we're not really pirate.
I like to say R-matey.
And we like saying R-matey, and we walk around with peg legs, and you know, and we fuck cabin boys whenever we catch one. But the point of the matter is that so is this your first time? Is this your first time tuning in?
Yes, I was just looking up shit on that Shoutcast, and like I saw you guys there, and I was like, holy shit, man, I gotta call in.
There you fucking go.
Outstanding.
Excellent.
He is on the IRC, actually.
Is he?
Yeah,
okay.
He is already in
Very
on the
cool.
IRC. I saw him there earlier. Well, what you need to do is, if you like what you're seeing here, you want to get involved with Cult, you can email me at kennedy@rantradio.com. And I'll give you some more information on how you, too, can become a mindless beyond bent on world destruction. Kennedy? Say what the hell?
Dude, Kennedy at what?
At rantradio.com.
All right, tight. It's fucking awesome.
All right, say what the hell.
What the hell?
There you go.
Hang up on the top. Oh. That's always off. There we go.
There we go. All righty. So let's talk about news.
Okay, we got a thing here.
Another call.
Is it two rings or what? Oh, well, it doesn't matter.
I think it was two.
Doesn't really matter. Yep, there we go. Another call.
And you're live on Rant Radio. Who's this?
This is Nomad Infloop.
Hey. Nomad Infloop. Glad to see you. Glad to be that you're a member. How are things going up in the Northern Wastes?
Up in the Northern Wastes? Well, pretty shitty, actually. I already told you guys last week that I'd be gone.
Right, yeah.
But I managed to get another week of looking for a job.
Hey, that's good. That's good.
Find any pedophiles?
No more pedophiles. No more of anything. There is no work. Here's my tip to all people that think about going up north. Don't.
Why? What exactly is the problem with Northern BC?
Where do I start?
Why can't you find a job? Let's start there.
Okay, well, everything is resource-based, right?
Oh, so it's like mining, cutting down trees.
Yeah, it's like cutting down trees. And then
sounds a lot like work.
Resource-based economy, which employs lots of people, to tourism and service, which employs 10 people. This is like one hotel out in the middle of fucking nowhere, run by some small family. Oh, yeah, and some chick with big tits that you want to fuck. And then Germans come up there and go, oh, look, we've spent money. And that's it. I mean, and then you have a...
In front of us, in the form of eggs.
That's about it. So there's nothing else that's going to be going on?
I fucking called that one.
No. Everything's shut down now that the school year is over at UMBC. The only reason... One of the main reasons why Prince George is still going.
I see.
It's now a total university town. That and the fact that
If you don't
mind
me,
need some advice on a job.
Do you need some advice on how to find a job?
Go everywhere.
Where do you need advice here? This was the advice. What is the actual advice you're looking for here? You have one free advice. What is it?
I'm gonna go out on a limb here. Away from the cesspool known as Williams Lake.
Okay, what you do? Here's what you do. How much money do you have?
Don't swim in the lake.
Okay, that's a given, especially if it glows in the dark at night.
Which it does.
Yes, it does.
All right, everybody, shut up. How much money do you have?
Okay, I have $75.
You have $75. And that's if you liquidate all assets or what?
That's not liquidating all assets.
Okay, so how much shit do you have to move?
Not much shit.
Not much shit? Okay, liquidate what you don't have to take with you at your local fucking pawn shop. If they don't have a pawn shop, sell it to other people. If you can't sell it to other people, steal some more money.
eBay. Then you can jack the price.
Then you can sell it on eBay, fuck whatever. Then all you need to do is you jump on side of a bus. You jump on the bus, come down to BC. Lie about your tech skills and get yourself a job. If that doesn't work, crawl onto a raft, pretend you're an immigrant, then you'll get yourself a job.
Won't be
a problem at all.
Okay.
So that's what I say, and sort yourself out.
Yeah.
All right.
Didn't say what the hell.
He didn't say what the hell, but that's all right. Now, moving right along.
Or, like Josh K says, there's the porn industry.
There's always porn.
Porn's always good.
Porn pays.
80% of the net.
I'm going to go out on a limb here, but I think he should become a serial killer.
It doesn't pay much. The pay is shit.
Yeah, but it's a great hobby.
It's like a really bloody mugging.
It is
bloody
a bloody mugging.
Anyway.
April 7th, 2000, Tokyo. Are you reading this, Sim?
Oh,
we have another call.
We have another winner.
Well, we're never going to get this story out. We should keep this story.
Yeah, we should keep this story. Wow, that's really funny.
You're live on Rant Radio. Who is this?
Hey, this is Fault Sequence.
Fault Sequence. Absolutely. I'm so glad you called. For everyone who's just tuned in now, Fault Sequence is a fellow I read the email about who was having some problems with his fucking butthead principal, who apparently is now running. What's going on down there, Fault Sequence? Let me know.
Basically some guy actually took the liberty to exercise some free speech in our school, which I thought we were told all along was what we were supposed to do, you know, think for ourselves and express our opinions. But no, apparently not. This guy distributes this pamphlet around school. He's talking about how everyone needs to chill the fuck out and just, like, not be disrespectful, not pick on the freaks, and, you know, all that good stuff. It was a positive paper. And he gets hauled in, and they're giving him a 10-day suspension, and they're threatening to expel this kid.
What grade is this guy in?
He's a junior, 11th grade.
I see, okay. So what happens next? So then you decide that you're like, whoa, this is really wrong, and you decide to take a stand on this, and what happened?
Basically, I haven't done anything yet. They don't even know about me. I'm just kind of an innocent bystander, but I'm looking at this thing, and I'm thinking, wait, okay, I don't have anything to do with this, but it's going to affect me, because they're fucking taking away kids' rights, and if not me, it's going to affect someone else down the line. And I don't want to do it. I don't want to get in trouble for all this shit, and I know I'm going to go down hard for it, but it's my responsibility. It's one of those things where you know you have to do the right thing.
Do you know, ever hear of a guy by the name of Reverend Martin Luther King Jr.?
Yeah.
He's a kind of a guy, got himself shot doing a similar sort of thing. But what he said was that a judgment of a man is not how he stands in times of complacency, but where he stands in times of crisis. And that's what actually is the making of a solid person, is when you can stand up when everybody else is fucking being, you know, when the world has gone to shit, and you can stand up and say, whoa, wait, stop, this is all fucked up. So that's pretty balls deep that you're taking a stand. Now, you were saying that two newspapers locally, I think I read earlier in the MIRC, the two newspapers locally were going and were carrying this story. Is that true?
Absolutely.
And how did they get that story?
I emailed them, both.
Excellent.
Excellent. And you did not get any... you didn't get any... Did you do it anonymously, or did you put your name on it?
No, I put my name on it. And they called me up, and they asked me a few questions about it.
So is your name in the paper?
I'm not sure. It might be. If it is, I don't give a fuck.
So it hasn't been published yet, or...?
It hasn't been published yet.
Ah, okay. Well, definitely...
I will have you the scans as soon as it is.
Oh, definitely.
Absolutely. On a personal note, I'd really, really enjoy that. And, of course, you know, as a shameless plug, if you could at all name in the newspaper that you got advice from someone on Rant Radio, that'd be fucking stellar. Because, hey, you know, it's all good. But, absolutely, hey, I'm really glad that that worked out. You obviously did the right thing, and you knew what the right thing to do was anyway, and you just needed some reinforcement, and that's fucking awesome. And I got to tell you, I know you're not a member of Cult, but, and maybe for whatever reasons, it doesn't really matter, but I just respect you as a person for standing up like that. That's fucking solid, man, I gotta say.
All right, I got one more thing to say.
Go ahead, buddy.
Up on you. Prophet Spidey, I've asked you politely, man, stop using the colors.
Okay.
Destroy your drive. Okay, that's all there is to it.
Okay, okay. One thing I would like to state at this time would be good. Okay, I want you to say, what the hell?
What the hell?
What the hell? All right. One thing I would like to state, now would be a good time, because you notice that the MIRC is packed. Yeah. Everybody's really solid. Now, there's one thing...
Speak into the mic.
There's one thing that I do want to say that we've got to get straight right now. Now, you'll ever notice, whenever you go into MIRC chat rooms, there's people who get into these big fucking flame wars, and they start showing shit back and forth. Oh, you suck. No, you suck. I punch you in the face. I hit you in the head with a Linux manual. Okay. Stop. All right. We don't do that shit. That's bullshit, all right? And... I don't have time for that fucking
just
shit.
Just type stuff. Don't...
Just type stuff. You're live on What the Hell. Who's this?
This is Lieutenant. What happened to ranttv.com?
It's down as well.
It's down as well.
It's
everything's
fucked till
down.
Tuesday.
It's all on the same server.
Everything's fucked. Dogs and cats are living together. It's the first sign of seven.
The missiles are in the air.
The cult thing, you know? Like the cult.
I know. The cult thing is also down. It's not my fault. They told me they fixed it.
Somebody didn't push a button.
It was the new guy.
It was the new guy. He pressed the button. Did you jiggle the cable?
I jiggled the cable.
Fuck. Okay.
FTV, you know?
No, I know. Say what the hell.
Oh, what the hell.
Other one.
But wait, Sean. Aren't you misstating something there? Because after all, it is all your fault.
Oh, this is true. It's all my fault.
It's all Sean's fault. He's the one who organizes everything and it puts it all together.
That's right. This whole station would not be if not for me. Yes. Wait, no, that's not how it
hey,
works.
Hey, K, Zendra, Zed, and Spotlight. Welcome to the IRC.
And lots of good people. Let's see what we got. Do we got any rants for these guys?
We have some rants. Let's play some rants.
Let's play some new rants. Here's a new rant from yours truly.
Sean, you can pick the rant.
Fresh meat.
Yeah, it's really good. What do we got?
We got Office Speak, Holier Than Thou, Linux, Microsoft, and Hippies.
Okay, let's play Hippies and Cult.
Okay.
Because, well, Cult rocks.
Hippies and Join the Cult?
And Join the Cult.
Okay.
For all of our listeners.
Here it is on Rant Radio.
What the fuck? Because you asked for it. It's your pal and mine, Sean Kennedy on Rant Radio.
That's just how it works.
Okay, so a lot of people want to be activists. They want to go out there. They want to make a difference. They want to do something for somebody somewhere that will, you know, really make a difference in the long run of things. So they decide they have to pussy right out. They have to become this, you know, total Lilith fair-going, patchouli-wearing sort of, you know, pussy who doesn't do fuck all. They just sort of sit around and smoke grass and sing to trees, you know, and talk about the dolphins and don't eat their tuna and all sorts of groovy shit like that. But it doesn't mean fuck all, okay? If you're not actually doing something, you're an idiot. Being an active member of resistance does not mean pussying way the fuck out. And people get upset if some member of the ALF eats beef. They are eating beef. How can you be a member of the ALF if they're eating? Shut the fuck up, okay? At least they're doing something. At least they're going out and trying to make a difference, as opposed to your sorry ass, which doesn't do a fucking thing, okay? So, if you want to go out there, hippies are not resistance. Hippies are the first to die, okay? That's what hippies are. They are cannon fodder, all right? They're the other guy who gets into the WWF ring, all right? That's what hippies are. Hippies are what happened to the political activists when they got stoned, when they got weak, okay? You never saw fucking guys like, oh, I don't know, major political leaders in the 60s smoking shit, unless you consider, you know, drug addicts of that time to be, you know, major political leaders and whatnot. I mean, Mumia Abdul-Jabbar, does he go and smoke grass? Probably not, but if I was on death row for a crime I didn't commit, fucking A, man, I'd be smoking up daily, but that motherfucker doesn't. Why? Because he's a hard man, that's why. Hippies are not resistance. If you want to resist, by all means, go out and resist, but don't pussy out and draw peace symbols on shit and start, you know, trying to do the cosmic awareness. I mean, every little bit helps. If that's all you can do, then that's all you can do. But I mean, by all means, try to motivate yourself to do something at least sort of constructive, at least sort of something that makes a difference. My name is Sean Kennedy, and I am the fucking man.
That's a rant radio!
You know what? I get up in the morning and I look around at the world around me. You know what I see? I see a world filled with poison. I see a world filled with venom. I see a world that got taken over by corporations. We don't have any choice left anymore. I see a world where people are being driven to the last notch. I see a world where fucking six-year-old kids are shooting each other in the fucking throat because the media taught them to. That's what I see.
Fuck,
you know what?
That.
I'm sick of it. I don't want to see it anymore, and that's why it's got to start.
Now!
I'm talking about the cult. I'm talking about getting together as a group and organizing. I'm talking about Deckers. I'm talking about vampires, flesh trippers, Ronin. I'm talking about the gargoyles. I'm talking about the whole fucking crowd of us all getting together and rallying under one giant fucking K. Why? Because I'm Sean Kennedy and I'm the fucking man and I'm the man who's going to bring a whole new system into being. I don't think it's time that we sit back and try to get it going on with another delegation system. I don't think democracy works. I think what we need is another king. I think what we need is we need something to be done. We need action to be taken. We need action to be taken just to protect ourselves. Never mind anything else. When was the last time you thought your neighbors actually gave a shit about you? Well, what if the online community actually got together, actually got organized? That's right, the kind of shit that the CIA's been fucking afraid of for years. Whenever a hacker pops up, they're a super terrorist! You think
fuck
that's good? You think
that.
That's the way to go? I don't think so, Holmes. I don't think that's what you want. I don't think you want to be taken away to some fucking jail cell somewhere and locked away after all your rights realized to be gone and nothing but a piece of paper that was long since forgotten anyway. You think that's what you want? No, it's not
fuck
what you want.
That.
You want
that.
To be real. You'd like to be part of a community. You'd like to be somewhere where people actually give a shit about you, and that's exactly what we're gonna do, because I am sick to fucking death of all the crap that's been going on in the world. I am sick to death of just ranting and doing nothing about it. The time has come to get organized, and that time is now. If you want more information about cult, you want to get involved, email me at kennedy@rantradio.com, and I'll set you right the fuck up. My name is Sean Kennedy, and I am the fucking man.
Queen of England for Rant Radio, take one.
Hello, this is your queen speaking. I've just finished... Good. Hello, this is your queen speaking. I've just finished sitting down with Charles for a spot of tea, and I've turned your radio show on. And I bloody well don't know what to say now, so I'm just going to ramble a bit, and... you see, you didn't know that all my speeches were edited, did you? Charles, help me! No, okay. I mean, I've been listening to your show. Oh, I got a little Cartney in there, sorry. No. Sorry. Okay, I'll do this properly now. This is your... this is your queen. Hello, this is your queen. And... oh, bloody hell! Now everybody knows I'm... not the bloody purebred British blue-blooded. God, alright, I'm from a bad part of London. Hello, this is your queen. I've just finished sitting down with Prince Charles for a spot of tea, and I've turned on your radio show. I've been listening for the past 3 weeks to your show, and I've just got one thing to say. I felt I must say something about it because I find it absolutely titillating. I love it. I tune in every night, and it's so funny. I love all those dirty words they use. Oh, it's so exciting. Much more exciting than listening to those boring government people talk all the time. Bloody hell.
Okay. Thank you, Queen. That's a wrap.
As your queen, I order you to listen to Rant Radio. I don't know if you want to put that in or not.
Hello.
Are we up?
We're down. That's okay. Okay. That was Prophet Quoth doing that little promo thing there.
Which was actually hilarious. That's
totally funny.
That's totally fucking funny. If you don't think it's funny, shut up. It's funny.
Shut the fuck up.
Okay. Normally at this stage of the game, we would be having gross hospital stories with Uncle Dak. However, Uncle Dak is dead.
Pussy dad! He got killed.
He got killed. We will raise him
Uncle
from the
Dak
dead next week.
Is merely hibernating.
Is he hibernating? That's pretty seriously pussy out that he pussied out for that.
It is,
but,
though.
But whatever. Whatever.
He's usually pretty good. He was whining something to me earlier about needing sleep or something like that. Oh, so we're a bunch of Dakless wonders for tonight.
Dakless wonders. Wonder. Oh, well. Whatever.
There's another radio show in the lower mainland here on the internet, and it's called Humor in Technology, and I just put the link on the IRC, and we got mentioned in that radio show,
actually.
Which
is kind of cool.
Which is very cool.
We didn't know that they were going to mention us.
I was just doing a search on the internet for Rant Radio, and it just happened to be like 3 days after they did this little mention on us, and they actually made a link to us and stuff like that. So it was very cool. And another song we're going to play after that one is to Lieutenant Major Zombie.
Yeah, this is for you. And everyone always he's in the IRC going, "Why do people make fun of me?" You know, we don't make fun of you. You've been around a long time. We love you.
We love you.
We love you.
You had that comical
relief. You're like the Jar Jar Binks of the IRC.
You are. You're our very own Jar Jar.
Nobody understands what the fuck you're talking about.
Half the time, and they want you to die, but you're there. You're there, and you make the movie a better, stronger place.
If it wasn't, you would have to be somebody else. And
that's right.
We couldn't have that.
Plus, we strongly suspect that you're made completely of CGI.
Yes. Yep.
So, and no one really looks at you. They look just above your head. So. If you could, go and just listen up, and we dedicate the song following this.
It's by the Bloodhound Gang.
By the Bloodhound Gang to Lieutenant Major Zombie.
There we go.
Anyhow, the thought that I was going along, there's a lot of humor that comes out of the Lower Mainland.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I mean, there's a lot of famous Canadians that I'm sure most of the rest of the world may not be sure and may not know. That the people are Canadian, but of course Canadians know that they're Canadian.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a whole shitload of comedy that comes out of Canada. And right here in the Lower Mainland, you've got User Friendly, Iliad's in New West.
Yep.
We're here in the bunker in Burnaby.
Mm-hmm.
The Burnaby Bunker.
The Burnaby Bunker.
There's, I've been watching Shoutcast, and one of the most popular comedy/talk stations that is listed there is from somewhere here in the Lower Mainland, Rant Radio. I don't know if you've heard of it or not, but they put it this way. They've got a bigger server than us, and they max it out.
Oh, really?
They're, like, always maxed out whenever I see them. There's all sorts of shit going on here online. Kind of we're usually about 10 years behind the States technology-wise, but for a place that is in that position, boy, have we got a lot of shit going on.
We only say about Vancouver that it's one of the most technologically advanced places in North America and perhaps the world.
Why is Ellie always picking on me?
likes you, monkey boy.
All right.
That was dedicated to zombie.
That's the Teenage Mutant Zombie because
that was
fake retards. But
we got bona fides.
But back from popular demand, we have real live retards.
You betcha.
And we're not making fun studio. Of them. We think it's great, and they submitted this to us, so we're gonna play some retard rock.
This is the kids of Whitney High.
That's right. Put on your marker vest and put on that face shield. Get ready to go for a romp and mosh and walk. Here's the kids of Whitney High with
Respect.
Are we back up?
No.
Uh-oh.
Yep.
No problem. I'll fix it. No way. I need to point to there.
This has been lots of dead air. All kinds of dead air here. He's like, where are they? They went away. We're gone. Where are we?
They need us.
Oh my gosh.
Connect. Come on. Oh my gosh. Tonight has been technical difficulty hell. Well, they did.
Today has been like the shittiest day of the last year.
Oh, for tech. It's been bad.
My truck again, stole my knife, stole
what?
All the shit.
No way.
Full knife? Is it full knife?
No.
Sunspots?
You lost your knife, man.
Your bench made.
Yeah.
Wow, that sucks on like so many levels. I've fully been there.
What did I learn?
Never take it
never
off you.
Never leaves your body. Well, the thing is, last time I rode it, the bike.
How's it going, man?
I stabbed myself in the leg, so it opened my pocket.
Oh, man. That's
so
brutal.
What do? You put an elastic band around the fucker. That's what you do.
All right.
Are we back up?
Yep.
You know, after listening to that last song, rap isn't so bad.
No, rap really isn't so bad. So, sorry. We had a bit of a problem there. But the truth of the matter is we just had a bit of bad news. Hungan Enki just had his fucking truck broken into.
Again!
And they stole all his
fuckers.
Shit.
Motherfuckers!
What's the deal with holidays? They do it on Thanksgiving?
Do it on Thanksgiving and on fucking Easter.
And Boxing Day.
Well, they've got nothing better to do. They're not working, you right?
Know,
so,
like, what kind of a fucking scumbag goes and, like, breaks into another... Like, if you're going to steal, steal from a fucking company. Why would you break into somebody's fucking car? Especially in Langley. It's not like there's a bunch of crack junkies here, you know.
Seymour. It's fucking North Shore. It's rich people.
So they're just breaking into trucks and taking their shit.
Bored
teenagers. If you're going to break into a vehicle, break into a fucking BMW.
Yeah, break into someone who looks like not some fucking truck. His truck got tagged, man. That totally fucking sucks, man. And, yeah, Flesh Tripper Rooster, that's correct. This is the same Hoongan Enki. He was out mountain biking, comes back, and his truck's fucking trashed. Gotta like that shit. Yeah, I know. It's full beatdown.
And a bunch of his kit got stolen, his wicked stuff.
He had
shovel death for these punks.
Oh, yeah, big time. Big time. And after all the work that Enki's done on the page, it's been fucking mighty, the amount of stuff that he's done.
Guys, we can't show you because...
You know, honestly, yes, we can't show you because everything's down. It's been a bad fucking day. It's been a tech nightmare all goddamn day, Spokehouse.
That's right.
It's just been fucking shit. The cult page is down. Everything's fucking down. Everything's fucking wrong. And you know you've been there. You know you've been there when you're sitting there and you've had a bad fucking tech day. Your tech day goes off. Everything goes wrong. And you're like, ah! And you have assholes phoning going, did you know the internet is down? No, you're only the 900th caller to call me and say the email fucking server's down. You're only the 900th one. Please call back in 20 fucking minutes and check if it's up again. Please do that because, you know, I can put you and cue you with all the other fucking people. Every time something goes down, I just want to get on the answering machine and say, I'm sorry, I know the answer, the internet's down, please fuck off, and I will get, and when it's back up, that means I've done my job. You phoning me will take me away from the computer problems and cause me to make it go on longer. Please call early, call often. It's just fucking bullshit, man. I cannot stand it. And then, of course, you know, you have Luddite fucking hell, where these people, like, think they're, you know, got a brain in their head. Well, you know, what's wrong with you? It's not a car shit for brains. It's fucking not like you can look in there, oh, the axis crack. There's your problem. Axe is cracked. You know, it doesn't fucking work like that, okay? It's a high-tech piece of machinery that all has to degrade. What's wrong with it? Don't you know what's wrong with it? Don't you know what's wrong? No, go back to fucking... Oh, man, it's so fucking bad. And all these people sit there and they just go off and on and on and on. You have to deal with it. People are like, well, why isn't it working? Oh, I don't know, actually. Oh, no, what are they paying you for? I jerk off to porn all day. That's what they pay me for. I can throw a load fucking 3 feet. Get away from me! My name's Sean Kennedy, and I am the fucking man.
I like the ending.
So, in any case.
Yeah, technical nightmare
it's been
or hell.
Technical fucking hell. And
we're dealing with it. We're up. You can hear us.
You can hear
deal
us.
Deal with it. This is what you get,
fact.
Right?
And you know what's really cool is we've had a very full IRC tonight, too.
Yeah, lots of people.
And there's been a lot of people running around and fucking doing shit. You know what's really fucking cool is the fact that so many people have sent in links. Capone X, who's not here tonight, but he's sending in links. He sent in some cult gifts and stuff like that. Yeah.
We like this listener support, and we need lots of
it.
Send
tons of
in
it.
Your stuff. There's lots of ways you can send it in.
Sure.
ICQ me, 51558. You can email me, info@rantradio.com.
If you want to do stuff for cults, you can email me at kennedy@rantradio.com. Go through the cult site that way. We got a whole bunch of stuff planned for cult. Hoongan Yankee's been going fucking crazy with it. He's got all kinds of great plans that are going to be happening. Another thing that's going to be going on is if you're not, you know, code proficient, you're not able to, you know, kind of sit there and figure out what's going on, do some graffiti or something. Take a photo of it. Draw a picture, whatever you like. Let's see who's calling in here. Hi, you're on Rant Radio. Who is this?
Lieutenant. Hey, I want to speak to Sean Kennedy.
Yeah, you're talking to Sean Kennedy. What can I do for you?
All right, if I ever go to court for downloading MP3s from Metallica or the DECSS program,
right?
You know what? You're going to be my lawyer.
Thanks for coming out. Okay, say what the hell.
What the hell?
What the hell? Alrighty,
yeah,
so...
Metallica or Dr. Dre comes up and sues.
Sorry to dump more on you, Lieutenant Major, but if you're looking to Sean K. for legal help, you need help of a different kind.
Yeah, talk about... yeah, like it's kind of a little blind leading the blind. But I actually, you know, I feel what you're saying there. And
they'll open the door to the courtroom for you.
Yeah, I'll open the door to the courtroom and, you know, I mean, my whole...
Possibly Sharon adjoining cell.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, grab your towel, head towards the showers, you know. So that's pretty much how that shit works. But let's move it right along here.
I got some news stories.
You got some news? Let's
do this one.
No, but don't call in. We're not answering the phone if you're calling. That's it. Call in is over.
Web links can be considered illegal, so don't post anything in Japan now. If you post a link to another page that is illegal stuff, you can be considered completely liable for it.
How fucked is that?
Yeah, so if we link to our friend's page and all of a sudden he he wants to put up some porn or something else, and we don't even know about it. We thought it was a cool page before. Nothing wrong with it.
And now he's got
all of a sudden, you're hauled into court. You'll have to go through the whole process.
What is wrong with that fucking country?
Another bomb on these people, somebody.
So let me understand this. If you post a link on your page that leads to a site that has illegal material, you're considered liable.
That's right. And isn't that crazy? How can search engines cope? I mean, are they going to have to go through and filter out all this?
Go to Yahoo.com, type in aardvark, porn, Yahoo goes to court. How fucking mental is that? However, as a footnote, where you want to run if shit goes bad is Italy.
Yeah.
Because just this week, we don't have the link. It's on the cult page, which is down right now. But there's a link on the page where if you got to run, got to hide, go to fucking Italy. Because a court ruled in Italy that if you have software that you get and you give away and you just acquire this software, but you don't use it to make money, i.e. you sit there and make links and give away all your shit that's free, if you get pirated software, it's okay. It's allowed in Italy.
You're not making money off of it.
You're not
so
making money
cool,
off of it,
right?
So it's all good.
That's
if you
cool.
make money
yeah,
off of the software,
cool.
then it's actually legitimately pirated. But in Italy, if Cimmerian gets his hands on a $7,000 program, he gives it to me and I use it for private whatever the fuck it is I'm doing and I don't make a dime off of it, that's okay. And if I post it and other people download it, I'm not responsible. It's what they do with the software.
That's right.
Wow, you know?
Freeloader mecca.
It is. I mean, fuck that. That's an amazing concept. Like, wow, who'd have thought? You know, the Italians, you know, they came up with this bastion good idea of culture.
Because the problems are the people who make these nice fancy packages and try and sell it as the legitimate product in stores like they do in Hong Kong and stuff. I mean, the MP3s aren't hurting it. I mean, the people who are selling and trying to pass it off as legitimate information are the ones hurting the actual people. I mean, it's only promoting the bands.
It's very serious. It's very, very solid. Josh K., I don't really know. Have I...
Been here.
Josh K., I know he's been here. I know he's been around forever. I don't know if he's actually... If I've got a cult submission from you. I don't have a problem throwing you up on the page, but I'm sorry. I'm getting so many fucking members now. Please forgive me if I don't remember you there. I'll confirm. If you haven't sent me one, please get back. You probably have. You've been there forever. If not, don't worry about it. Just send it to me, and I'll put you in. Another thing. This is beautiful. Dr. Dre is, of course, suing Napster.
The ultimate hypocrite, Dr. Dre.
Holy fucking shovel in the head for you. You're going on and you're selling my music and you're trading my music where I talk about fucking killing white people and Jews and shit. And now you're trading my music illegally. I'll bust a cap in your ass, motherfucker. I'll rape your bitch. But wait, now Dr. Dre is being sued by George Lucas.
He's more powerful than God.
Who is more powerful than God. And he's being sued for what? Exactly the same thing.
He sampled the THX intro.
And he
never fucking paid any duty. So he's suing Napster for people trading his music without paying for it.
Yeah.
And he's taking other people's music, which all rap groups do, sample music.
Everything's sampled. Everything.
Yeah.
Like Thrill
Kill
Cult.
That's what the whole thing is based on, is taking
great.
Other people's
it
music.
It sounds good. It sounds good when there's more samples. Hell, the amount of shit we sample, the MPAA could fucking kill us.
Except for in Canada. So
oh, except
they
for
can't.
Canada, so you can't do fuck. Oh.
So but, it's just another hypocritical example.
Fucking dick.
Fuck you, Dr. Dre. Your music sucks too.
Well, you got a big shovel award on the page. So nice big fucking shovel for you. So I guess we're kind of rounding up actually on 11 o'clock.
Sure.
Things are moving up. But just before we go, we're going to post a link about... Yes, that's right. Bible Man. Yes, Bible Man, the superhero for the Christian community. Nobody, like, if anybody can get me a Bible Man fucking action figure, by all means, fire it in. Oh my God, do I ever want to
get your parents' credit cards out.
Yes, that's right. Bible Man kicks ass. Bible Man is a superhero. And who apparently, I don't know what he does. He looks pretty menacing there, though.
In 1999 alone.
I'm confused already. If he's a superhero, that means he has superpowers, powers above and beyond the normal human. Now, doesn't Jesus Christ and God Almighty himself be the only person that has those powers?
I don't know. It's probably bestowed upon him by God.
Oh,
just whacks people in the head with Bibles. I don't know.
He's Bible thumping.
He's a Bible thumper.
Bible wilder.
He's Bible wilding. Yes. And not only that, but we posted a link earlier where you can actually get a Jesus Christ
smiting.
Action figure.
What does he do? Just hang around?
Yeah, he just, walks
unfortunately,
in and gives a guy 3 nails, says, put me up for the night. I don't know what he does. He
unfortunately, he doesn't come to Langley, B.C.
conquering. But, oh, this is a guy?
Yeah, it's a guy. He
it's
does
not
a
an
tour.
Action figure?
The Bible Man Adventure Live 2000, Conquering the Wrath of Rage Tour.
Oh my God, where does he go?
Please call 1-800-651-1535 to confirm dates.
Okay, but he's going to California. He's going all over in California. He's going to Texas.
Let's see if he's coming up to Canada.
Oh, yes, by all means, let's call him.
So, fucking Prophet Fork, they and Fork there, and everybody else down in Cali should, like, try to jump on the bandwagon.
Oh, swing by. Give us some photos, yeah.
Yeah, fuck
you betcha. Check out the links. So we're going to phone up Bible Man here and see if he's going to come to Canada.
Oh, Bible Man's closed.
Bible Man's closed, and they have a really, really quiet answering machine, too.
Hello, we are the quiet answering machine for Bible Man.
So I don't know if you heard
do
that.
Not wish to offend.
Oh, I got a question for you.
Yeah.
How's that lawsuit with you working out?
Oh, doing pretty good. Nobody's actually sent me anything, so.
Oh, okay, cool.
So I'm still in the clear. Nobody's suing me for spreading DVD decryption codes just yet.
And even if they did, there's nothing they could do about it.
I'll just run diddly.
He'll either run diddly or he'll just have an accident. You'll find a body in a car with no dental records and no fingers.
Looks like Sim to me.
Yeah, that's Sim. And I'll fall to my knees.
I saw Sim drive off the cliff.
I swear to God, I'll like show up, there'll be a big pile of ashes, and I'll fall to my knees and go, oh God, Sim, why?
Why'd you do it?
Why'd you do it? Oh God, those filthy
Heavenly
apes.
God, Heavenly God.
Oh, Heavenly God, oh, Heavenly God, oh, Heavenly God, oh, Heavenly God, oh, Jesus, Heavenly God, I'm halfway down the stairs now. So, that's about it for tonight. We're going to go around the room and say
sorry
goodbye.
For all the technical difficulties.
And, yeah,
it all
the technical
fucking sucks.
Suck.
I mean, we've had these kind of shows before where
but
it's like, hold down.
Before we do that, I have one link to check out.
Okay. What do we have?
I found the end of the internet.
You found the end of the internet?
The end of the internet?
Oh, he's putting a disk in my computer and it's going to fry it.
An executable on that
I mean, it would top the evening up. Anti-Canada.
Oh, there we go. Anti-Canada? Anti-spam Canada? Okay, we got a link that's coming in. Just fucking be cool. This whole show's gone to shit. The whole show's fucked. And the really cool thing is
I think it was Dak, because Dak wasn't
here. We've got a totally full IRC channel, too, and it's very fucking cool.
And you stuck with us on our most sucking night yet.
Yeah, we've been sucking some bad bags.
You've seen the best. No, here's the worst.
Here's the worst.
Attention, please. You have reached the very last page of the internet. We've hoped you've enjoyed your browsing. Enjoy the rest of your life, because there's no links. It's it. That's it. You're here. That's the end of the internet. Thanks for reading. Thanks for sticking by. You know, that's the end of the internet.
That's an awesome
that's
fucking page.
That's very cool. That's a very cool page. Because that is what kills it. Like, the internet is made of links. So that's it. Okay, so here we are. We're at the end of the show. Nice little end there.
And we'll go around the room and say goodbye. There's a goodbye from Cimmerian.
Bye-bye, bye-bye, bye-bye.
Over to the final goodbye.
This
chicken.
Is the for chicken saying, months. I will see you in 4 months.
Yeah, we may hear his voice, but this is the last time you'll see him. Yeah.
Last time you'll see me.
And it's Sean Gay, fucking man, saying, dear God, let this night end.
And Raven Lunatic agreeing.
Thank you for being over.
Oh, the humanity. The humanity. Oh, the humanity.
It's so bad. Yeah, that's pretty much my sentiment.
That was even.
Yeah, his mic's pretty gross. Don't go near him.
All right, and saying goodbye.
That was a pretty shitty puke job, too.
Yeah, he was having a technical. Okay, going around the room. Gargoyle, Mr. Echo. I sound like I'm drunk. Oh, fuck it.
Never.
It's all fucking gone. Fuck you.
Thanks, Mr. Echo, for manning the IRC.
As best as you can.
Yep.
Ephedrine, goodbye. Fault Sequence, goodbye. FT Rooster, Flush Tripper, good to see you. Stuck around. Gargoyle, Josh K, see ya, Hungan Midget, see ya, Infobot, see ya, love that Nixter. You never did put your goddamn name on there. MW Radio, Nomad, Buck X, Nomad, Smokehouse, good to see you guys. Prophet, Rancid Girl, good, glad you're with us. We need lots of women, get more women. Cult needs women. Send more chicks.
And Ronan.
And somebody get us some vampires. Some crazy, one of those Elvira goth bustiers. That's what we want. You know, the tight bustiers. They have to apply in person at my house when my wife's not
home. They have to measure up.
And then we have...
Remember, your wife knows how to listen.
Yeah, my wife knows how to listen. I'm fucked. More technical difficulties to follow because mine will get kicked in the nuts as soon as I get home. Prophet Diener. Prophet Fork. Prophet Scribe. good to see you, man. Hope things are doing well. Looking forward to seeing you. Barbecue, Prophet, Zerostorian. Rommel fucking Stilskin. Whatever the fuck your name is. Romulan. Rommelstar. Fucking fuck you. I can't say your name. Prophet Spidey Spider. Prophet Spider. Good night, everybody. We're all going home now. Thank you.
Thank you for coming.
We're all fine here. We're all fine here.
Thank you for listening to the insanity. Later, Scribe. And how are you? How are you doing?
can we at least turn the goddamn show off?
Be nice what? If we could turn how the fucking... do we turn this off?
How do you turn? Oh my god, it's gonna broadcast.
If you're still listening to this, you should be asleep.
Are they? Are we still broadcasting?
This concludes our broadcasting day.
Okay, we're out of here. See ya. 22 hours and 6 days and all that stuff. You know, next week, Sunday, 9 p.m.
1010.
Tune in. Tell your enemies. Tell your friends.
1001.
Here we go. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
You have just listened to another episode of What the Hell on Rant Radio. Tune in next Sunday at 9 p.m. Pacific Standard Time to find out what happened to Sim and the rest of the gang in the dramatic continuation of What the Hell.
Ah, laddie, this What the Hell show! You rot your brain!